I built this really cool tavern on my Twilight Forest 100 Days video, and people liked it. I even got a couple comments that were like, wow, Zloy, it only took you 6 hours to build something I wouldn't be able to build in my entire life. And like, thanks, but you don't have to take yourself down just to pay me a compliment. So if you think that you could never build something like that in your entire life, this video is for you, because I'm gonna show you exactly how to do that. We won't be using any modded blocks, and the build itself is primarily made out of stone, wood and bricks, so you can build this in any Minecraft world pretty much ever. I hope you enjoy seeing me put this together, and if you build your own one, definitely tweet at me at ZloyXP. So let's begin. We start of course with the outline of the basement with a rounded square shape where we're not gonna be filling in the corners. So technically it's a 9x9 on the inside. In reality it's 11x11, just the corners are knocked out. Then we want to go 3 segments to the right to create a little bit of a key shape. The recipe here is 3 brick blocks, then a smooth stone, and repeat that 3 times. Put 2 blocks down sideways, 5 cobblestone blocks, 2 blocks sideways again, and then just mirror the opposite side. The cobblestone here is actually gonna be a large furnace, like a chimney that we'll be using to heat the tavern. And same with this little nubbing of 3 cobblestone blocks on the opposite side. That's going to be the oven for the basement kitchen. Next, you want to grab some stone walls and put them on top of the smooth stone blocks. Put another stone wall on top of it, and then another smooth stone block on top. Switch to the cobblestone wall and fill in this shape of 3x3 with the upper corners knocked out on every stone block segment of 3. Fill in the corners with full stone brick blocks and build some pillars behind the stone brick wall blocks. Now as you can see, we got a shape with quite a bit of depth to it, and I'm quite proud of it. Now back to the square shape we started with, and that's as simple as extending it upwards by 3 blocks. I'm breaking up the segments using cobblestone, stone and stone brick, and replacing the corner blocks with stone brick walls for extra relief. We're doing it pretty much on each side, except on the back wall there is the little nubbin that's gonna be the furnace. Finally, we fill in the chimney I promised, and I place some cobblestone wall blocks at every break in the pattern of the main square. These will serve as supports for the support pillars of the first floor. And yes, we are now moving on to the first floor, so if you're building this in the survival, I actually recommend you put in a floor at the top block of our basement so you don't have to fall as much. We put spruce wood pillars on every single cobblestone wall and on every smooth stone block across the build. And then we plug those pillars up with some dark oak planks and connect the sideways section with a full long plank across it. I also decided to outline that plank in trapdoors, it just looks more detailed. The square part actually has a full log as a support beam. From there, we continue the pillars with dark oak planks by 3 blocks and once again put a horizontal plank across that. The segments between the planks on the rectangular part, we actually decorate using trapdoors as well, but we're putting them perpendicular to the entire build. We'll be doing a little bit of trickery of depth with this build. Instead of keeping our walls straight and flat, we'll actually be receding them by 1 block and putting down those trapdoors to make the facade look more intricate. You'd think that basically having a hole in a wall wouldn't look good, but turns out it actually looks really nice if you look at it from afar, and nobody is gonna ever look at it not from afar, given that this trick is used on the second floor. And yes, we're using birch planks and stripped birch as the backdrop color for the rest of the build. That's the one problem with this trick we're pulling with the trapdoors. The backdrop for them needs to be the same approximate texture as the wall, but only the blocks visible from outside, so if you want a different block for the floor here, you can have it. We fill in the walls of the first floor, not forgetting to leave a window opening for the rightmost part of the rectangular shape, a door for the middle one, and nothing for the leftmost one, because that one is only 2 blocks wide. This minor bit of asymmetry is not gonna cause us any trouble, I promise. It's a minor sacrifice we have to do for the rest of the build to look as good as it does. Onto the second floor, we fill in the floor and put down stripped birch log as the lower half of the wall and regular birch planks as the top. Same for the square part of the build, and yes, basically every single segment that has 3 blocks in it, we're leaving a window in the middle. Here's a nice flyby of every side of the build in case I haven't explained something good. And things are about to get really triangle because we are about to hit the roof. Now on every dividing pillar of the dark oak, we'll be putting 1 extra block on the same level as our birch planks, sticking 1 block out and creating this triangle that's gonna be kind of amping up for the roof. Starting from there, we actually assume the block stair pattern, and continue it until our beams meet down the middle. We can even put two slabs and a trapdoor between them to connect these segments together. The bigger facade is not gonna be as easy. Here we actually create this little arch meeting with two more support pillars made of planks down the middle. Those pillars made of dark oak actually will go right through that arch and higher into the next segment, which itself is going to mirror basically the exact same shape as the rest of our roof. Once again, it's a stair block kind of a slope meeting with the support pillars and of course itself down the middle. Put one of those on either side of our tavern, and the remaining side we're just gonna bend the stairs from our sides three blocks inwards and doing the same shape once again but smaller on the remainder seven blocks. Now the frame for all of our roof is complete, and it's time to go get a ton of red brick or whatever else material you want to use here. In my experience, nether brick or even deep slate tile should serve you just nice, but I just really wanted a splash of color, so I settled for the brick made of clay. We still need to fill in all of our walls, of course, so birch wood with birch planks for everybody, and don't hesitate to use the dark oak fence posts as the windows themselves. If you want the exact pattern I settled for, it's just a 2x1 window on either side inside the little arch, and everything on top of it was supposed to be originally filled with birch, but then I realized I can put some windows in it as well and added 3x3 birch fence post windows. By comparison, this side of the chimney is utterly boring and kind of flat, so if you can come up with a variant that isn't, I'll be happy to see that. For me, it's the side with all the chimney, so I'm kind of satisfied as it is. Finally, it's time to break out the brick, and we actually will be making the shape here a little bit more intricate than it has any right to be. Instead of placing all of the brick stairs horizontally in a row like we did on the lowest area, I'm placing them sideways and leaving a full block of gap between them. Then I'm filling in the gap and putting the next layer of the brick with a 3x2 of the full brick block. I repeat this process until we meet down the middle at the very top, and of course I mirror it on the other side. And I gotta admit, this looks pretty freaking cool. It may not be healthy for a brick shingle roof to sag this much in the middle, but it looks really nice and it creates a much more interesting shape. Finally, it's time to fill in the big section of it, and that is as simple as following the lines of the frame of the roof that we established into each other until they collide. The corners here are gonna be a little bit tricky. Feel free to pause the video and cross-reference it, and also keep in mind, this does not actually have to be exact, because chances are no one is ever gonna look closely at your roof from this angle. It's just the roof. If it keeps the rain out, we're great. And at this point, if we did everything nice, you should have yourself my 3-4 story tavern with a basement and the attic fully available for your survival shenanigans. There's a basement to potentially lead into your mines, and I personally really like the attic. It's pretty creepy and pretty cozy up there. But it's absolutely up to you what you want to do with this tavern. I hope you're happy with your build as much as I am with mine. Thank you for visiting. Sign the guest book by clicking subscribe, and I'll see you next time.